Arkhangelsk was founded in the 16th century by order of Ivan the Terrible. The protector of the city is the Archangel Michael. On the coat of arms, the Archangel strikes a devil. Arkhangelsk is a city rich in maritime history, a spiritual cradle, and the center of trade for the Russian north. At the end of the 17th century, on the high banks of the River Dvina, rose the white-stoned Gostiny Dvor, an arcade where overseas traders bought and sold their goods. Peter the Great ordered the construction of the first stone fortress of the Russian north, Novodevinskaya Fortress, which protected the Arkhangelsk port from its enemies. These ancient walls still impress those who pass the threatening citadel.
Arkhangelsk is a city of trade. Before the October Revolution of 1917, the city's central streets were occupied by private residences of bankers, steamship owners, and lumber barons. The spirit of that epoch lives today in these carefully restored buildings. Painstakingly recreated details evoke centuries past, such as the oak parquet floors, Russian tile stoves, marble window sills, and ancient furniture in Plotnikova's residence. Old merchant Arkhangelsk survives today not only in the ancient interiors and black and white photographs. The avenue of Chumbarov-Luchinsky, also called Arkhangelsk's Arbat, is closed to vehicular traffic, enabling one to experience Arkhangelsk as it was 100 years ago. Here, near the ancient building of the Commercial Council, the people of Arkhangelsk celebrate with the very first New Year tree in all of Russia. Today, the shops, cafes, and restaurants along the avenue of Chumbarov-Luchinsky attract residents and visitors alike.
Another favorite tradition of the citizens of Arkhangelsk is to stroll the embankment. There is no better place to experience the well-known Arkhangelsk phenomenon of the white night, when the sky remains light all night long. At other times of the year, the embankment provides a dramatic vantage point from which to admire the sun setting over the Dvina River. Arkhangelsk offers rich and varied cultural opportunities. Its lively and progressive theater troupes are a mainstay of the cultural life of the city. The most famous of these is the Youth Theater, referred to by the locals as the Panov Theater, in recognition of Viktor Panov, its founder and main director. The brightest and loudest event of the northern summer is the International Festival of Street Theater, when Arkhangelsk rolls out the welcome mat for citizens and guests of the city.
The Russian North is a land that has preserved its unique indigenous culture and remarkable national traditions. The one-of-its-kind collection of northern religious icons is a pearl of the Arkhangelsk Regional Museum of Fine Arts. It boasts one of the best collections of icon painting in the country. The museum also presents a collection of classical painting, including masterpieces by the painters Ivazovsky, Rarik, and Vrubel. The antique arches of Gostiny Dvor are lined with exhibits that depict how the ancestors of today's Pomor people lived, what they believed in, and whom they traded with.
Those who wish to experience the awe-inspiring architecture of the old Russian north will enjoy a visit to Malye Kareli, an open-air museum of traditional wooden architecture. Malye Kareli is a village comprised of historic wooden structures from throughout the region that have been dismantled, moved, and reassembled here. Picturesque landscapes, ablaze with autumn foliage, surround ancient temples, peasants' log huts, and rustic mills. A special time to visit Malye Kareli is at Shrovetide, when we say farewell to winter. Here, in an atmosphere of a national holiday, visitors can savor blini, real Russian pancakes, and to warm themselves with a cup of fragrant tea while enjoying traditional northern shangas, potato-filled pies, and the region's famous cloudberry jam.
If you like active holidays, you will love Golubino. After a scenic bus ride, you will find yourself in the very heart of Piniga, a protected ecological reserve renowned for its flora and fauna. Here, visitors may choose from a number of guided tours and excursions to the secret depths of the northern taiga and to the enchanting Piniga caves. In the long northern winter, one won't be bored in Golubino. The mountainous landscape offers excellent skiing and snowboarding opportunities. Guests can rent ski equipment to challenge themselves on the steep slopes. After a strenuous day, visitors may treat themselves to traditional Russian cuisine or European dishes prepared by our highly skilled chefs.
For centuries, the northern forest has offered its visitors more than just mushrooms and berries. In both summer and winter in Arkhangelsk, the rivers and forests provide excellent hunting and fishing. The Dvina Delta is especially noted for its duck hunting and ice fishing. The ancient source of sustenance for the indigenous Pomor people of the White Sea coast was the sea. For hundreds of years, thousands of fishermen and trappers ventured forth on small wooden boats to the far islands such as Spitsbergen and Newland. The tradition of northern navigation continues into the 21st century. In the middle of July, dozens of yachts sail from Arkhangelsk to the coast of Solovetsky Archipelago. This is the Solovetsky Regatta, the main sailing race of the White Sea.
The Solovetsky Monastery was founded in the 15th century. It is considered to be the most northern Russian Orthodox monastery in the world. The magnificence of the monastery's ancient walls complements the amazing beauty of the natural landscape. Unforgettable views over the forests and lakes to the sea reward those who ascend to the highest point of the mountain Sakira. The innumerable lakes of the Big Solovetsky Island are linked by a system of channels. One of the most popular excursions for visitors to the Solovetsky Islands is a boat trip on these archipelago lakes. Any visit to these islands must include an exploration of the Solovetsky labyrinths. They date from the same era as Stonehenge in England.
The lands of Arkhangelsk offer its visitors endless surprising discoveries. Unforgiving and severe at first sight, the North's natural landscape blossoms with bright colors. A remote village may brag of the tallest wooden church in the world, and a small town far from roads might boast of dozens of beautiful temples. Not to be missed are Kargopol and Kunazeri, Pomor villages of the winter coast known for their bounty. The forests of Krasnoborsk abound with nature's delicacies. This hospitable land rewards the curious visitor with unforgettable discoveries matched only by the warmth of her people. Arkhangelsk is easily reached by convenient flights from Moscow and St. Petersburg. The overnight journey by train provides unparalleled views of the region's forested landscape. Arkhangelsk is connected to Central Russia by the 1,200-kilometer route M8.